Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about very interesting concept which is available in Jira Cloud Instance. So let's say if you are writing or creating an issue which will require some format to refer, then probably we will end up with no templates available within the Jira. But we already have one add-on which is available here. After using that, we can generate a very interesting templates, and based on that, we can use it for generating a descriptions and comment within our Jira instance. So let's say you are writing or creating a defects and you are ending up with not having proper format, then probably we'll use this add-on to generate a very interactive descriptions for any issue types. So here we can use that add-on for proper template format, and based on that, we can use in any of the projects for generating a descriptions format. So we will use this template throughout all of the Jira projects for generating of issue types, descriptions, and as well as for adding the comments in the format. So that will look very interactive and very pattern format or very descriptive format for all those details which we are filling it up. So that add-on name is Descriptions of and Comment Templates for Jira Cloud, which is built by Technoform. So if you want to install it within your Jira instance, simply click on this and this will navigate it to the next page where you will see all those details about this add-on. As I said, this add-on is built by Technoform. So if you want to install and use it, you can try it for free for 30 days. After that, if you want to extend this license, you can reach out to the Technoform for pricing model. So I'm just hitting on try it for free. Click on start to install. So it will take few seconds. After installation is done, probably we will be able to see this detail available within our app sections. So let's wait for few seconds. After that, we will use this add-on. Now, if you can see, this is successfully installed. What all you can achieve with this add-on. So after installations, we will navigate it to the default templates and project types. From there, we can build the template, and whenever it is required, we can use this template for generating a descriptions or proper format descriptions within our Jira instance. So here we have already installed, and let's navigate it to the app sections into the Jira instance. So let's refresh this. Now, once the installation will be done, you will see description templates. Click on that and this will navigate it to the page from where we can install Chrome extensions. Why the Chrome extensions? Because we are using Google Chrome browser, but if you are using Microsoft Firefox, Edge or Safari, you will also have this add-on available for those browser as well. Again, this will take some time, so get it configured, and once the configuration will be done, you can see descriptions and comment templates for Jira has been added to Chrome. You can see it here. Now if you want to enable it, simply enable this, and I'm just disabling the others. Now you can see this is available. After that, once the installation is done, configuration is done, just navigate it to the projects, and from the project section, you will have all those details are available. Now, let me refresh this page and then probably we'll start creating the templates. So here we will use bug, or maybe I will use bug. So here I will use the template and then bug. Now, if you can see here, this is the templates, and here earlier, we won't be able to see the descriptions with this title. Now, if you want to add the samples, add templates contained to the current field, okay. And you can see all those details which is available here is added successfully. Now, if I want to edit, these are the solutions. Simply, if I want to remove it, simply I will click on the error or maybe warnings or maybe with the success or note or informations. So these all details are available. You can select any of the tiles and do it accordingly. So if you want the open questions, so generally you can add as the informations, the note sections, you can add it, success factor, warnings, error. And if you want to remove any of the patterns, simply you will be able to remove it. In the environment format, let's say I want to add the environment format detail. That is also possible. We can edit it. But as of now, I don't want those details are updated. So simply what I will do, I will select each of the sections and delete it simply. So here, let's say you want to add any other sections like this one. So I will select this T1, and with the T1, we have this options available. With the T2, let's say there's a no save template in this position. So that's why it's not available. But here we have the sample templates. That's why we are able to update it. Now click on create, and this template is added successfully as a CM11. So if you will navigate it to the view CM11, you can see within the description, story, background, detail, scope, dependency or impact, risk, acceptance criteria, solution task, these all templates descriptions are getting updated. Now, if you are creating this detail, probably when you are using a bug, this will automatically reflect it. But if you are changing it to any other fields, and probably you won't, you will be able to see the different factors. Now this time I want to update it with the different assets or different templates. So probably there is a no save templates in this positions. Now earlier we have added for defect template, but for other issue types, we can also use the other fields. So here we will use for the story. Maybe we can utilize for the other fields. Now here I'm just keeping the template as default. And for this, maybe I will remove all those solutions like this, because there is no templates available for other fields. We can use the templates default here, but because we have already created for the defects, so whenever you will select the defects, you will see this options are available. For sample, let me add it here. Maybe I don't want the background, so I will remove it. And once this will be done, so this default templates is available for others. So this is the view issue. Now if you can see here in the story, we don't have the background. So let's say while creating the story, which all options we will have here. So while creating the story, we have the story details, scope, dependency, risk and acceptance criteria. If I'm selecting the defect, so probably this will update the fields with the background, dependency, impact, risk, acceptance criteria. So we'll create it here after giving the details. So this is a defect using Techno4 add-on. Now once I will add this defect, we'll probably will go with this defect, and here we have the comment options. Now within the comments, we can also add different formats. So if we want to save any of the comment options, we can select it from here. Now if you can see, we are also adding any of the details. Probably if we want, we can update the fields whenever it is required. We can make the changes, and whatever details we want to save it within the comment sections, we can have those comment details are available. So this is how we can set it up for comments and descriptions, where you can define the descriptions with the proper format and based on your organization's requirement. These are default templates, but if you want, you can customize this template for your project use. So this is how this add-on will be helping us to draft the detailed description. Sometimes what happens when we are working with the projects and the scrum master and business analyst is most of the time occupied, they are not properly filling the details. And whenever the business analyst person is also creating, they are tied up with the multiple things. They are not getting the proper time. Probably they will add a descriptions, a single link descriptions, which is not at all suggested. So for referring the details, probably the person or whoever the person who is building this requirement, probably they have to drop an email or reach out to the person who has created this issue type. So to avoid this and saving the time of all those resources, probably it's better to use this type of format and define the detail within the descriptions and comments, so that any person who is working on that does not have to go through and or drop an email through and through. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And if you need any suggestions and feedback, you can add your suggestion and feedback within the comments. Or if you want to reach out to the Technofor, probably you can drop an email to the Technofor team for any feedbacks. That's all. Thank you for watching.